Hello, everybody. This is Dr. Carlo Oger, emergency physician and medical director for emergency department. This video is about scapholunate dislocation. I'm making this video because we had a case of a lady who sustained a wrist injury during a car accident. Even though the x-ray did not show any traumas, it did show a significant finding that was not addressed or communicated to the patient. It didn't really change the management because the patient was properly splinted and referred to the orthopedic doctor for the next day, and she did follow up, so the injury did not go undiagnosed. But however, we would have liked to have had a proper diagnosis and maybe an attempt at fixing the problem. This is the x-ray of that patient. So the next slide is going to talk to you about the sign that's showed in this x-ray. The sign is called Terry Thomas sign, and Terry Thomas was an eccentric British comedian. The sign's also been termed David Letterman sign, but it could be also termed a whole bunch of different stuff since there are a lot of celebrities with that finding. So you can see the common denominator here is the separation between the two front teeth. Of course, there's no teeth in the wrist. If you look at the left picture here, that's a normal x-ray of the wrist. At the right, there's a you can see the arrows pointing to a separation, a widening of the two bones, the scaphoid and the lunate. The Terry Thomas sign refers to an increase in the scapholunate space on an AP radiograph of the wrist. The increased distance indicates scapholunate dislocation, often with rotatory subluxation of the scaphoid due to ligamentous injury. There is no consensus as to what measurement constitutes widening. But a cutoff of 3 to 4 millimeters between these two bones is reasonable in most cases. The scaphoid ring sign. A radiodense ring seen over the distal scaphoid representing rotatory subluxation and foreshortening of the scaphoid. Only seen when ligaments attached to both ends of the scaphoids have failed, collapsing the scaphoid into flexion and pronation. Increased scapholunate angle. The scapholunate angle measured at an intersecting line between the axis of the lunate, which runs through the midpoints of the convex proximal and concave distal joint surfaces, and can best be drawn by finding a perpendicular to a line joining the distal palmar and dorsal borders of the bone, and the axis of the scaphoid lying through the midpoints of its proximal and distal poles. More than 70 degrees is suggestive of dorsal intercalated segment instability, or DISI. There's a differential diagnosis to the injury of scapholunate space. The Kienbock disease, a condition of uncertain etiology that results in osteonecrosis of the carpal lunate, and a Prieger disease, in which a vascular necrosis of the scaphoid occurs. The treatment. Surgical referral of the scapholunate interosseous ligament is usually required to prevent long-term complications. There are varying surgical approaches depending on the severity of the tear and involvement of secondary stabilizing ligaments. Complications. Complete SLIL rupture leads to significant changes in force transmission of the carpal bones and predisposes to degenerative changes of the carpus. Cartilage degeneration, loss of joint mobility, obviously pain, scapholunate advanced collapse or SLAC slack. Beware of the sprained wrist. This is the diagnosis we say a lot, and this patient left with that diagnosis. However, 100 consecutive cases who presented with wrist pain associated from an acute SL instability. A clenched fist view was included in addition to the routine AP and lateral films. 19 patients initially found to increase SL gap on plain films. 13 out of those 19 had asymptomatic and bilateral. 1 out of 19 had scaphoid fracture, and 5 out of the 19 deemed to have significant SL instability and remained symptomatic with continued radiographic changes 12 weeks and follow-up. So injuries producing significant ligamentous damage and carpal instability may be as common as scaphoid fracture, 5% incidence. Hey guys, I want to thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned a lot. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, share. Go to theedexitvideo.com, which is a shortcut to my YouTube channel, or edexitvideo.com, which is a specific channel for patient education videos. Again, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.